Good evening and happy Friday to all of you. A whole mess of big football games in our area tonight, and you'll get to see the highlights in our Football Frenzy show in just a few. But first, local reaction to a new study on concussions in high school sports. Some good news and bad news coming out of it, and Christian Garzon breaks it down for us.
In a new study from the National High School Sports Related Injury Surveillance Database, fall sports like soccer, football, hockey took some hits.
It's brought a lot of awareness to concussion. I feel like we're in a much better place right now when we talk about concussion and treat concussion.
Dr. Daniel Day with Rochester Regional Health reacted to the finding that boys football, girls soccer, and boys ice hockey had the highest concussion rates. But Day says there were some positive points in the study.
Concussions within practice decreased.
Recurrent concussions also decreased, but concussions during actual gameplay did increase. Dr. Day and his team are trying to figure out why.
There's a lot of factors that can certainly play a role in that.
Day and his sports medicine team don't take any chances when it comes to their concussion patients.
Within that return to learn and return to play, we're really giving them a good chance to recover, and by the time we're clearing them, we think the brain's recovered and we think that they're safe to go back.
At multiple games across town tonight, attendees say the climate on concussions is changing for the better.
People are erring much more on the side of being safe.
A lot of parents that I see, we talk about like concussions, and they are against their kids playing like rough sports like football.
And I feel like there is more awareness in like just taking precautionary measures.
I like that they're taking it more seriously.
I think that they're doing a really good job changing the helmets, changing the calls, just really watching out for the kids.
Since diagnosing during a sports event can be difficult, Dr. Day has one line of advice on game day.
When in doubt, sit them out.
Now, another interesting part of the study points to cheerleading practice as having a high rate of concussions. So lots of layers and levels to that study that's having an impact right now on the national concussion conversation. Adam, back to you.
All right, Christian, thank you. For more information on this concussion study, follow the link attached to this article at rochesterfirst.com.